In this video, I'm going to look at solving the types of linear ordinary differential equations that show up in kinetics. In particular, we're going to look at a batch reactor where a simple A goes to B reaction, but it's reversible. Both reactions are first order as a constant density system, and so we can write a mass balance in terms of concentrations for this reactor. And A is going to react in the first four reaction used up, but then it's formed in the reverse reaction. We want to solve this differential equation. It's an initial value problem. So at time equals zero, our concentration in the batch reactor is some initial concentration. And so what we're interested in is what's the concentration of A at a later time. We're assuming concentration of B initially is zero. So if I rearrange this equation to write it in the more normal form, I'm going to want to do two things. Concentration of B, I'm going to write it from stoichiometry. I could write a second equation, but I'm going to write from stoichiometry. Since there's no B initially, every mole of A reacts forms a mole of B. So my differential equation then becomes, to do the solution, I'll define a couple of variables to make it easier. Alpha is a constant because K1 and K2 are constants. They're not dependent on CA. And the right side we'll call beta, another constant. So this is a first order ordinary differential equation, right? This is to the first power. And this is the kind of equation we can solve with an integrating factor. And the idea of an integrating factor is that we have some value mu that when multiplied by alpha equals mu prime. So this integrating factor turns out to be an exponential of the integral of alpha dt, which in our case, because alpha is a constant, it's e to the alpha t. And then the solution using integrating factor, won't go through all the details of how this is derived, solution is going to have beta times the integral of e to the alpha t plus some constant divided by e to the alpha t. So the solution is beta. If we do this integration, e to the alpha t over alpha, and then we have e to the alpha t plus k e to the minus alpha t. So the concentration of A is beta over alpha plus a constant e to the minus alpha t. So this is known as the particular solution. And then this is known as the homogeneous solution. And the constant K we get from our initial conditions. We know at t equals 0, CA equals CA0. So that means CA0 beta over alpha plus K e to the 0. So now I have the value for K. And so now what I've done is write the concentration in terms of time and beta and alpha. And then I've gone back to where I defined beta and alpha and put it back in terms of the kinetic parameters, the rate constant, initial concentration. So this is how the concentration of A changes as a function of time for a reversible reaction of A going to B reversibly. And we started out with just A in the reactor at a concentration CA0.